हेलो मैम, वेलकम टू द हिस्ट्री।
या थैंक यू फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी।
यस मैम, आई एम कृतिका एंड आई एम वेरी एक्साइटेड टू हैव यू हियर विद अस टुडे। इट्स सो ग्रेट टू सी ऑल द थिंग्स यू आर डूइंग फॉर द नेचर। इट्स ट्रूली एन इंस्पिरेशन फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस। मैम, द हिस्ट्री एज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज डेडिकेटेड ऑन फोकसिंग ऑन फॉस्टरिंग पर्पसफुल लर्निंग इन किड्स एंड ऑन अकेडमिकली अनटच्ड एस्पेक्ट्स like reading, storytelling, gardening, etc. So ma'am, being an environmentalist, what is the one habit that you feel the kids should develop to be mindful about their environment?
I think the kids can just try and not buy new things, not buy new toys, new clothes, maybe try and see if they can share it with their friends, from their friends, you know, so that lot of resources are being shared among and across us. And we actually have so much and so enough that we can create so many things out of what we have. So maybe we all along with the kids can do that.
Yeah, wow, ma'am, that's really very nice. Wow. So now I will let the kids take over this interview because they're equally excited and very eagerly waiting for having a conversation with you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody. I'm Anumeha, a student of grade 4 from Bageshwar, Uttarakhand. Welcome to this episode of Goodness Interview. Today, I feel very happy to talk to you. And only one thought came to my mind. Use those talents you have. You will make it. You will give the joy to the world. Take this step from nature. The words would be a silent place if no bird sang except who sang the best. And it's happen only when we do what we do right now. We can make it. We can make the world a better place.
Rightly said, Anumeha. I am Krishna, a student of grade 8 from Bageshwar, Uttarakhand. Hope you all are doing well and staying safe in this pandemic. All of us know what is good and what is bad. We all know that we should take care of our beautiful planet, Earth, and coexist with the animals around us. But the question is, what are we doing to make it right? I am so glad that today I am going to know about a person who shelters hundreds of birds and butterflies in her balcony, Mrs. Arudhati Mahatre. Ma'am, it's our utmost pleasure to connect to you.
Thank you so much for the warm welcome. And yes, absolutely. Environment is just so important and we are so much a part of it. Yeah, so thank you so much for the warm welcome.
Ma'am, a moment I get to know, I'm going to meet you. I'm very excited, but before we jump to our conversation, would you like to tell us something about Arania and how are you feeling to be a part of something good?
So yeah, so you know, I used to travel a lot and take a lot of photographs and you know, do a lot of nature study. But then I realized, you know, I am trying to, you know, just again bundle up all the joy and happiness and all observations for my own self. So I thought, I think I should share it with everyone. And so we thought of, you know, making a lot of small feeders and shelters and kept it in our balconies and windows and kept grains, food grains, a lot of varieties of food grains in it. And the birds like parakeets and sparrows started coming on it and eating from it. Yeah, so it was a joy which we were sharing with them. And when, you know, many friends used to come, when my son used to watch, the birds coming, it was just amazing. So I think it's just amazing when you share what knowledge you have and what happiness you see in the nature with everyone around. So it's just an amazing feeling.
Wow, that's really very amazing, ma'am. Ma'am, I'm very confused about what I should become when I grow up. Did you feel the same when you were a child? Or do you always wanted to be an environmentalist?
Krishna, I never knew what the word environmentalist meant when I was a child, you know. So I absolutely was confused and had no direction, absolutely. But yes, there was one thing which I knew as a child was that I loved dogs and cats. And so I always wanted to be a veterinary doctor when I grew up. But eventually, life had different plans. Yeah, and I did not become a veterinary doctor. But yes, I wanted to be a veterinary doctor very much. Yes. So it's absolutely fine, Krishna, if you don't know at this point, and Anumeha, if you don't know at this point that what you want to do as when you grow up. But it's fine till you are searching and your curiosity levels, you know, everything around you make you very curious.
Yeah. That's great, ma'am. Ma'am, please tell me, what do you like the most about being an environmentalist?
The most amazing thing, Anumeha, which I feel being an environmentalist is that you become a futuristic person. You know, you actually are thinking about future. So, you know, before this pandemic came, okay, we used to always have our medicinal kadhas. We never had our allopathy medicines. We always did natural remedies. We did so many things which nature offered to us all by itself. We were not shopping so much. We were not traveling so much because we knew that, you know, when we do all this, when we shop all this, when we spend a lot of money, then you are buying some resources which are, you know, actually, you know, been really taken from the nature itself. So you are a futuristic always, and you know what is going to come in future, and you are very well prepared for the future. So that's the best part being an environmentalist, because, you know, nothing changes for you even if pandemic comes. Even if, you know, because you know what you are expecting from the future, which common man doesn't know because they are just not aware.
That's nice. But ma'am, I know every good thing comes with some challenges. So I want to know, what do you consider as the most challenging part of your life or being an environmentalist?
You know, Krishna, here I would like to go a bit personal, because you also told ki what is the challenge that you are facing in your life. You know, the challenge that you face in your life is that you can't sit with your school friends and talk with them, because they talk all about buying a new car, buying a new flat, okay, or sending your son to or your daughter to, you know, big universities, because it hardly matters, you know. What matters is, as long as your son or your daughter is curious enough, you know, if they are searching within, they are thinking aloud, you know, it's more than enough. You don't need to send them to higher degrees or send them to high universities, because eventually, after, I have seen that many people just leave their job, IIT jobs and IIM jobs, and come down and you know, go and stay in their villages and start, you know, their own startups. So that's what is more important for them, to really search inside and know what their passion is from, you know. So it's very difficult. The challenge is to go and sit with someone your friends, you know, and have a chat, because everyone else is really busy with something else. They are very much busy, you know, Krishna talking about their own lives and planning their own lives and planning their own money and future and things like that. So it becomes difficult for you to really, you know, go and talk to them. Yes.
Mom, a few years back, I used to go to my hometown on summer vacation. So summer vacations, and loving to see colorful birds and different butterflies there. What is your favorite childhood memory, and what did you love doing the most in your when you were a child?
So, you know, my native place was Alibaug. So the best memory that I have, whenever I used to go to my native place, I used to be very busy going in the backyard of the house and catching dragonflies and damselflies. And the damselflies and the dragonflies were so beautifully colored and so small, and you know, just, you know, catching them was quite a task. So it was amazing. And I remember the things that I was always busy was like plucking flowers to make bouquets, and plucking grasses to, you know, to really try and make the place good and decorate it with grasses and flowers. Yes.
Wow, it sounds so nice. Ma'am, I know you have a bird shelter on your balcony and so many birds visit it every day. Can you please tell me a few little things that I can do or put out on the balcony so that I can to see beautiful and colorful birds every day?
So yeah, Krishna, you know, there are very small things that you can do, and it takes no money at all. So whenever we have, you know, when you order food from the restaurant, there are small plastic dabbas, you know, the takeaway boxes. And even when we cook in our house, you know, we use coconut. Yeah. So there are coconut shells, half shells that are remaining. So we can just make three holes to that plastic takeaway box or the coconut shell, and just tie thread on the top of it, you know, and hang it in the balcony, outside our balcony or in the window, and put some grains, anything that you eat, that is the, if you are eating rice or if you are eating wheat or any grains that you have, you just put it in the feeder, and believe me, the birds come and peck the grains from those feeders, and it's just amazing. It's just amazing. I don't need an alarm clock in the morning because my feeders are all ready, and the parakeets come there at around 6:30, 7 o'clock, and they are all making so much of noise and waking me up. So it's just amazing to wake to, you know, the calls of the birds, and it's very much possible. Anumeha, you are on mute, dear.
Thank you, ma'am.
Anumeha, I would like to even add one more thing. So I talked about the birds, right? So you can do something about butterflies also. You know, there are very, very simple plants like the lemon plant, Mimuka plant, you know. So you can just have such plants in your balcony, you can have the curry leaves plant, kadi patta ka plant. You can just keep those plants in your balcony, and you know, or terraces, whatever places you have. And then the caterpillar, you know, is the butterfly is the best botanist. You know, the butterfly knows the botany very well. They sense that there is a curry leaf plant or a lemon plant, so they come to that plant and lay their eggs, because their caterpillars only eat eggs, only eat leaves from that plant only. So they lay eggs, and you know, you can see that there are small caterpillars, then they change the colors, and then you can, if you really observe carefully, then they will turn to pupa and then the butterflies will emerge. So it's even an excellent way of attracting butterflies, and just when you see that butterfly emerging, it's like just magical. So along with the feeders, you can even have such simple plants in your, you know, terraces and garden, and it can be just amazing to see the butterflies.
Wow, ma'am, these are some simple things. I will also try them too. And on the back side, I would feel very bored inside my home now. So speaking of being stuck inside our home, ma'am, what do you like to do now at your home? And what are your favorite pastimes?
Yeah, so Anumeha, ideally, you know, I have made a farmhouse my home. So, you know, so that's if you can do that, it would be great, because then you can sow a lot of things, you can plant a lot of things. But being at home, you can even do in city also, you can do a lot of things. For example, you just go take some mustard seeds, okay, and try and grow your own microgreens. You can take some moong and chana, you can take some flax seeds, you can take some tilka seeds from your kitchen, and you can grow your own flax seeds. Many a times you don't even need soil. You can try and grow flax seeds and till like things, you know, in just water. And then when they become so big, then you can just cut it and then make sabji out of it. So it's just amazing, and it's all power packed. So you can do so many things just staying, you know, indoors. You can just when you go to the market, you buy pudina. So you can just, you know, keep aside the thick stalks of pudina aside and put it in water, so it will start rooting, and then you can make, you know, put them in the soil and have your pot of pudina. You can do so many things, sowing and, you know, growing so many things. And believe, when you work with mud, when you put your hand in mud without gloves, okay, just bare hand in mud, you really feel amazing and great. And when you pull the kari patta leaves from your kari patta plant, which is growing in your house, it knows your touch. And so the plant knows that, you know, what should they produce so that they can heal us. You know, what problems do we have? So our plants know us if we are growing them. So we should really have, you know, something that's grown, created at our place. Yes.
Ma'am, you know a lot about birds and bees. Can you please tell us some interesting facts that you have learned about birds, something amazing that only a few people know about?
Absolutely. There are many experiences when you have, you know, a shelter box, when you have feeders, then you keep on seeing, you also keep on seeing and observing birds. So, you know, they always say that you should eat, you know, tulsi seeds, that is sabja seeds, in the summer. Normally in the summer, we soak the sabja seeds and then drink that, you know, or put it in your... So I had seen that when my tulsi had seeds, the parakeets were sitting on that tulsi plant and eating the seeds out of it, eating that flowering plant part which has seeds. So, you know, the birds themselves are supposed to eat the seeds of tulsi because it will cool themselves. So birds do have a lot of wisdom, and other animals also have a lot of wisdom, only that we don't know about it. So that was the amazing thing when I saw that a parakeet is sitting and eating the tulsi from that. then I have observed so amazing things that, you know, I had a few. It was Dashera, and Dashera ko hum jhindu ke flowers laate hain. To usme na, we have a lot of worms. So I kept the worms outside, and the sparrows came and started eating those worms and taking some worms for their bachas. So it was so amazing. It was just amazing. You know, in that sense, I used to even keep some lemon grass, which I used to use in my tea. And after using it in my tea, I used to wash it and just keep it in my pot. And then the sparrows used to come and pick up the lemon grass and take it in their shelter box and then lay it there, you know, and make a bed out of it. So it was just amazing to see. And the birds and the bees knows a lot of things, you know. Now I would like to tell you about bees. So nowadays, from last few months, I have been handling a lot of bees. So there are people who want to, you know, relocate beehives that are in their terraces or in their balconies. There are bees who come and make hives in their balconies. So, you know, I have been helping my friend to relocate those bees. So what we do is we try and cut the beehive that is there in the balcony and relocate it to some wild places, like we have national parks or we have mangroves. So we try and relocate it there. So you know what happened was, I wasn't having any glows or anything while handling the bees, and the bees didn't sting me because they can sense the fear of person. If my intention is to take the honey, then you know I have that fear, and my the signals that pass through me are different. But here I was trying to save them, trying to help them, and they could really sense for what reason I was there and why I was handling or disturbing them. And they did not sting me. So that's so amazing, you know. Your vibrations, your feeling, your fear, everything gets transferred to them. And they are so sensitive and they are so super intelligent than all of us.
Wow, ma'am. Now I will tell this to my little sister. She will be so happy to know. Ma'am, what are your one message to share with our younger generation to aware them for the environment?
I really feel that you children are amazing and you have a lot of magical power, and you can really, you know, connect to nature very easily. So I think you should keep believing in that magic and keep thinking very out of the box. Yeah. And maybe one thing that you can do is, of course, it has to be done along with the adults, is that let us try and not buy new things. Only if we can, you know, try and reuse things, try and share things which our friends have, you know. So if we try and really see that we have so much things, do we really need new things? Whenever you feel, you should really ask a question: do I really need to buy, or I can reuse something? If that is a small thing, if we all do and put it in our mindset, in the algorithm, you know, when we always want to buy things, that do we really need it? Can I borrow it? Can I steal it? It's absolutely fine. Yeah, because that would really help the Mother Earth. Yeah.
Ma'am, we have pretty much covered all of our questions and enjoyed every moment to talking to you. Hope you enjoyed it too.
Yes, absolutely. It's amazing because I feel that you children are, you know, are the guardians of the nature and the future, and you really aapke kandhon pe bahut kuch hai, you know. and we are just going to perish, and you all are going to rule the earth. So it was just amazing talking to you, and hope so I did not tell you things which were really heady, okay? But believe me, just keep looking at a few birds, at bees, at butterflies, at plants, and it would be amazing. You will be amazed to find so many magics around you. Thank you. It was amazing talking to you both and every one of you.
Thank you for your time. You answered all the questions so beautifully. If there is anything that you would want to ask from us, we will love to share.
Yes, I would really like to know, Anumeha, what is it that you really love and are passionate about? And at this point of time, without thinking, what do you think? What do you love? Yes, Anumeha, I would like to know what you love. Without thinking, you can just answer me.
Ma'am, can I tell?
Yes.
Ma'am, in this pandemic time, I love to watch birds and dogs and cats playing and many such animals around us. And I visit forests in every week, and I love to visit there.
Wow, that's amazing. Yes.
I also like, I like to see birds and all. And sometimes I play with birds, and one day I've caged the bird, and it seems so beautiful.
That's just amazing. That's just amazing. You can just create a shelter box of your own and just keep it. You know, you can just read out. There is a lot of material available on how to create your own shelter boxes using old things like shoe boxes or, you know, like the oil cans or something like that. And you can make your own bird boxes, keep it in your balconies. And it would be amazing when the sparrows or parakeets come. And, you know, I remember that one of my friend, owl, had come to, you know, make a nest. And it was just amazing. It was just amazing.
Great, ma'am. And thank you, ma'am, for your kind.
Yes.
And for giving us such a great information about these salts.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.